Well, today we're going to talk about bat weight. Is it better to swing a lighter bat for bat speed or a heavier bat for distance? Well, according to Google, the heavier bat will drive the ball farther. Now, there's an equation. We won't go into that kind of stuff. But I'm going to ask some of my guys out here hitting today in the hitting club what they think about that issue about heavier bat, lighter bat. Always my get background. A lot of big comments from this guy over here, man. This guy's a talker, dude. Let me get with. Yeah, tell me what you think about the heavier bat versus light bat. What a bat weight do you swing?
I swing a 26, 26 and a half, and
have you always swung a lighter bat?
No, I always stayed pretty much in the middle of 27. Then, of course, when I was younger, 28, 29, but 27s was. But lately, since it came out with the new bats, the technology, to me, the older you get, it's just like running, throwing, hitting. You need any little advantage you're getting, and just that 1 ounce mentally, throw helps me, and it's, you know.
And do you use a lighter bat as you get on in the tournament, or just?
I use a 26. All of mine are 26.
All of 26.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, I pretty much stay with that. That way, I don't have to worry. And, you know, befuddle my mind. 1 ounce, like I say, makes no difference to me. You know.
John. What do you think about the discussion about a heavy bat versus a light bat as far as hitting the ball farther? What weight bat do you swing, first of all?
26.
26.
26 and a half. To me, lighter is better, faster bat.
Yeah.
I think it's a personal preference, but I think that too many people get older and they say, oh, I'm going to swing a heavy bat because it's slower. But a lighter bat gets you more speed. It definitely more power.
A guy I met in Tennessee, and I'm going to put it on this video, he was maintaining that because the weight, you can't make up the distance with the speed of the bat, which I kind of disagree with, and I think physics may disagree with that too. But there is a formula out there that, well, let me put it this way. The general consensus is if you can swing the heavier bat as fast as you can swing the lighter bat,
Then you should swing more power, yeah.
Yeah, you swing the heavier bat.
If you can.
If you can.
But
that's not.
As you age, it's very hard to do.
Yeah, and you got definitely more control with the lighter bat. And you swing.
To 27 to 28, they tend to load the handles as opposed to the end of the bat. So the heavier bats.
I'm going to check that out with Masenko. But what we were just talking here is that in this heavy bat, light bat, the way they balance these bats today, I was reading where there's a thing called MOI, motion of inertia, and it changes the impact of the bat on the ball, which makes you can have a lighter bat, but what you do is load it in the end, John.
Yeah, you got your weight actually at the ball as opposed to in your hands.
Yeah, so they're putting more, and they've been doing that more and more. And that they got this 24-ounce bat.
What's your name?
Smoke.
Smoke. How big boy are you?
Big enough.
I know, but what are you, about 5'10"?
I'm 5'9", weighing 195.
Dude, you hit it like the biggins. Great swing, man.
Thanks.
Smith is in a hole. Bobby Gilbert's doing what? Down the road somewhere. Good swing right there, Moose. Smoke, come on, baby. Good swing, Bill. We need a five ball here, guys.
3 for 3.
Now, who am I talking to? Hi, this is Steve Wilkins. Everybody calls me Smoke. I'm from Breckenridge, Colorado.
Just to tell you folks, let me look at the setup here. This guy was bombing them here at the Home Run Derby. And he's telling me something that is a little different than what my knowledge, but I want everybody to hear this. And go ahead and explain to me what you're saying.
So my research shows that when you use a weighted bat, a heavier bat like this one, the amount of bat speed you lose by using a lighter bat isn't enough
This guy plays
to
tennis,
diminish
huh?
your return on, the exit velocity with the weighted bat, meaning more mass and weight going towards that ball is more important than the loss of bat speed.
Yeah, loss of bat speed.
Come on, Eric.
So you maybe, what do you have to start now? I saw you, which is very unique also. I have two bats, and you just explained to me. One, you had a 30-ounce bat. And then when you felt like you were kind of strained a little bit with strength, you ended up going to the lighter bat. Is that why you used that?
Yeah, and I only used it for one time because I hit a knuckleball. And another one back to. I figured I would go back to the weighted bat because even if I only hit it 320, it was still good enough. And when I started, I was trying to hit him 400. So I figured 320 was still good enough. So even though I was maybe not swinging as hard as at the first two, three shots, I figured I still needed to get two more over, which I did.
So you know,
two more over with the 30 ounce bat.
I'm gonna look into that. I'm an experienced, but I'm a guy that goes lighter. I'm 77, so it's a little different for me. But I think
exactly.
I've gone the other way, but. You know, I've always believed also, like I'll swing at 27 sometimes at the beginning of a tournament, and I'm down to 25, 26.
Exactly, same thing, same thing.
But hey, you know, because you did so well, I'm going to try it myself, but then I'll put it out in my audience and let them discern. I have a lot of arguments with a couple of my buddies down in Florida where they say, oh, the heavier bat, I get the more. But, you know, I'm just going for base hits most of the time, so I want control.
It's all the if you go to the those cages that have the statistics, it's just physics.
Well, I got to go over here.
You don't have to argue with physics.
I see. Yeah, I got to see my man here shaking his head. Why were you shaking your head? So, I want to hear what you're saying.
Let's go, guys. Come on.
Off of what he said, if you want the actual physics of it, let me see.
Okay, I'm game. I'm open to anything, man.
So for a 30 ounce bat, once he gets to this point. 30-ounce bat is actually going to, you've gotten to that point, and a 30-ounce bat is actually going to help you because it's going to carry forward. It's going to help you by using the weight to carry forward. Where a 26-ounce bat, once you get to this point, you're going to have four less ounces, and you're having to push it further. So basically, you've got two men using this bat, which is the bat and you. This bat, you've got one man, which is you and your wrists, and you're having to turn it over, if that makes any sense. I've never actually done this, but I'm gonna suspect this bat's gonna hit the ground first.
Hold on. Okay, go ahead. Which bat hit first?
30. You want to know why? Because once he got to a certain point, the 30 took over.
You got me intrigued. I'm 57, been playing all my life, and started using a 28-ounce bat.
You did again
when I was
just so it's yeah, not.
Well,
a
let
myth.
Me tell you, but 28-ounce bat when I was 40, dude, and I've been considered a home run hitter in my day. It was like tie there, wasn't it? No.
30. The 30 is gonna hit every time. It's just physics.
Well, you look now. You did. I mean, you know physics. You sound like you do. I don't know.
I know numbers.
Okay.
And I work with high school baseball players. So,
oh, do you?
Yeah. So
you're in this business.
I know the swing speed stuff.
See?
I'm big on swing speed.
And that's the way. Same thing. Looking today, Bruce Meade used to swing a 38-ounce bat. You know, but he's 6'7".
If I can get Suncoast to make a 32, I would swing a 32.
A 32.
But they won't make one. I've asked them.
Because now everybody believes in it, right?
Well, because this is to force this bat to be 30, they have to. They try to explain it to me. They add an extra sleeve at the end to make it a 30 instead of a 28.
So it's a matter of manufacturing.
It's just a manufacturing. So they're not used to making bats that heavy.
Well, you know, hey, I love this conversation, guys. And look at my channel. You'll be out there. You may change some minds. I don't know. Hey, I'm all for whatever works, dude.
I was always trying to do everything he did. I can still remember every lesson he taught me. Growing up, learning how to be like my old man. Thank you. was a lion. We were father's pride, but I was defiant. When he made me walk the line, he knew how to lift me up.
He's consistently had a 27-ounce bat, and he's happy with that. Don Clatterball, again, he used to swing a 38 aluminum composite. He uses a 28-ounce bat. So there's a trend here, as you'll see as we go through these players. The next player is Big Boomer Hutchison. Big Boomer. He used a 38-ounce bat, but he's about 6'4 and about 260. And now he uses a composite 28-ounce bat. We come to the next player, who is John DeVitti, and John's a little smaller guy. He's about my size, 5'10", and about, you know, 2-something. He used a 30-ounce aluminum. Now he's down to 25, 26, and he's my age, about 76 years old. And, of course, we move over to the big Mike Masenko, and that he was like inhuman. He was swinging he's considered to go to softball, like the number two player of all times. He used a 41-ounce bat. He told me he had 11-ounce end load at one time because they made the bat special for him. And he used a 35-inch bat. It was custom made by Steels. He stopped playing in 1999. He was using a 32-ounce bat. Okay, this is a picture of me and Bruce Mead in Maui, back when I was about 55, I believe. Both of us are swinging Mikens. Both of us are swinging 28-ounce Mikens. So, you know, Bruce has come down. I've been swinging a 28 since I was 40. But Bruce was now into the 28, and that's when he finished out his career, swinging a 28. So the whole trend was lighter bat.
Okay, this is my bats in my garage. Just to show you that I got all kinds of bats that I've tested, and there's probably 8 or 9 that I've bought this year that I've purchased and sold to someone else right away after I, you know, took a few swings with it, didn't like it. I'm pretty particular about the bat I swing because of the size. Dave Reed got me into the 12-inch barrel years ago when they first came out with it, and I've been swinging a 12-inch barrel for a long time now. And this end load, as we've talked about in the video, has changed the whole concept of the heavy bat. Some think, and I agree with that, that the end load compensates for the lighter bat. I mean, you got a lighter bat overall, but the load's in the end, and it's called the moment of inertia, which makes a huge difference. But the bottom line that I'll get to in my summation of what's going on is that you swing the bat. Obviously, there's the formula of you swing the heaviest bat you can. If you can swing the heaviest bat fast, you can swing the lighter bat, you want to swing the heavier bat. But that's not usually the case, especially when you get old. And it depends on your hitting technique, how you do that. They all intertwine. I'm going to explain that in a video. But this gives me an idea that I just don't talk about the bats without using them. And I get serious about looking into different aspects. I've had constant battles with some of my buddies about the lighter bat versus the heavier bat. And just like Smoke makes a good argument for him, and dude, he can hit it with that. I know a lot of guys hit with a heavy bat. Their techniques support that, and their age and their strength supports that.
Facts. The sweet spot on all softball bats are between 6 and 8 inches. If the bat is 14-inch barrel, then you have 6 inches of no sweet spot.
If it's a 12-inch barrel, you have 4 inches of no sweet spot. So what's happening with a 12-inch barrel, you're creating more mass. And when you create more mass, it increases your batch speed and your MOI. Now, how does that tie in with the three T's of hitting? You see that technology, bottom line, guys, with these composite bats, it's up to you to decide. If you look at this chart here, the three T's, you took technology, that's a helpful part of it. But you got to look at the technology compared to your technique, and then will your timing support your technique with the weighted bat that you're going to use? So they're interchangeable, they work together. The technology will help you if you use the right weight, the right size, the end load's a factor. Everything's a factor that we went over. So you got to decide. You got to do you. If you do you, you're going to be fine. You go ahead and find out which one works for you. Like the 12-inch works for me. I've been using it now for 10 years, I think, since Dave got me into that. And he's a big supporter of that. And I do realize how fast the bat is once you get it rolling. It does come around faster. And there's an old saying that I always use in my corporate world. It was, it's not the strongest of the species that survive, nor the most intelligent. It's the one most adaptable change. In any part of life, where it's the corporate world or your athletic world, you need, or if, even for longevity, you need to change if you're going to be the change is not just to be changing, but to be adaptable so you can be more successful, either living longer or losing weight or hitting the ball better. So you decide what weight you want to swing, and that's the weight you should swing. Hit at a 700 to 750 average. Don't worry about the long ball.